Okay, but that's not actually my fatwa.
Okay, what's your fatwa?
My Blue Apron box was stolen from in front of my apartment.
What?
I was so upset.
Your Blue Apron box was stolen?
Yeah.
Those are expensive.
They are expensive. Also, like, I plan my groceries around them, so I didn't have anything to eat. And I called up the delivery service, and I, like, yelled at them. I was like, well, I didn't yell. I was, like, very stern because I don't yell. But I was like, my package never got delivered. There's an issue happening, and they refunded me.
I feel like you're yelling, but anyway.
And then I go downstairs the next morning, and I look in the dumpster, and someone had dismantled the Blue Apron box because they were responsible enough to not just steal but also dismantle the box and make it flat. And I picked up the box, and I looked at it, and it was my box because it was my name on it. Then I was like, oh, there's some motherfucker in this building not just stealing my Blue Apron, but they're using it and then dismantling the box and throwing it away very responsibly, which is this other level of stealing, which I just infuriating. So then to figure out who it was, I was like, I'm going to prank them because I am a juvenile teenager at heart. And I got another box, another like Blue Apron box. And then I like Googled pranks. And most of the pranks were like, you should get dog poop and put it in the box so that when they open it, like the dog poop falls out, which is very genius. I've looked at the construction of this.
I have dog poop I can give you.
I will come for your dog poop next time.
All right.
But I also don't like touching dog poops, which is why I don't have a dog.
Fair.
So then I found one, which was like, you use those New Year's popper things, you know, the things where you like pull on it and yes. it's like explodes.
Yes.
Confetti. You know, it's pleasant confetti. So I rigged it so that when you opened up the box, it would pop confetti all over. And then it says, stop stealing my shit in a note inside it. Instagram story, the whole thing. And so then I put the box out. I put it out around 5 o'clock. And then I keep like opening the door and I don't have like a little peephole. And then 15 minutes afterwards, it's gone. And then I start wandering around my hallway just trying to see if I can hear like poppers going off. And then I knew which people hadn't come home yet because there had been a note in the door that our management had put. I assumed it was someone on my floor to have seen it within 15 minutes.
Did you hear it?
I think I heard the corner house. And then I started talking to all my neighbors that night too. And I was like, did someone steal my package? They're like, why are you having packages delivered to your door in this neighborhood? And I'm just like, that should be, it's my right as an American to get a Blue Apron to come to my door. And then I figured out which apartment it was because I heard a lot of commotion. Then I was like, oh, that's the building that the cops are always coming to. And I was like, oh, I don't want to start a fight with MS-13.
Oh, boy.
So I'm not going to do any more pranks. But I was really I was really all about it for that weekend. I got kind of a little obsessed with it. And now I have a stockpile of boxes of food delivery services from friends, of empty boxes that I can turn into prank boxes.
You gave MS-13 a confetti surprise.
I did.
Also, can somebody please animate that entire story? Oh, my God.
If you were a friend of mine on Instagram, you would have seen my explosive box.